Hare Krishna, Padmamukhi, Zhao Shang Hao. Om Ajnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chatsurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaihevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasudeva Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're reading the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, and we're hearing about Narada Muni. He's searching for the person who has received the greatest mercy from the Lord. And so he had gone to first of all Indra, and then he'd gone to Indra, he went to Brahma, and then he went to Shiva, and now he's going to see Prahlad. He's hearing about Prahlad Maharaj.
首先，Narada就去了Indra，天帝Indra那里，然后又去了Brahma那里，之后又去了Shiva那里。现在呢，Narada将要去找Prahlad Maharaj。
He's hearing about the glories of the devotee of the Lord. Alright, so... So Prahlad is given as the example of the greatest devotee.
Prahlad是最伟大的奉献者的表率和典型。
Describes that when Lord Nrisimhadeva appeared, he tore apart Hiranyakashipu. And at that time, Lord Shiva and all the other demigods, including Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, they witnessed with their own eyes the incomparable good fortune of Prahlad.
在那一时刻，所有的半神人以及幸运女神都亲眼目睹了普拉德的不可思议的、无可比拟的好运。Lord
Shiva, Brahma, and all the demigods, including Lakshmi and Garuda, they saw the killing of Hiranyakashipu.
主Shiva, Brahma, 还有其他的许多半神人们以及奉献者们, 包括Lakshmi和Garuda在内, 都目睹了主杀死Hiranyakashipu.
So they had actually seen Lord Nrisimhadeva appear.
他们事实上看到主Nrisimhadeva是如何显现的。
And they saw how Lord Nrisimhadeva had very special kindness for Prahlad Maharaj.
他们看到主尼申和戴夫对普拉德马哈拉着怀着特殊的爱意。So
although Prahlad is born in a family of demons, we should understand that he's actually a great devotee. He's a great Vaishnava.
尽管普拉德马哈拉着诞生于一个木恶魔的家庭，但事实上他是一个伟大的奉献者 Vaishnava.
So Lord Nrisimhadeva's appearance is described in the seventh canto, Srimad Bhagavatam. So Lord Vishnu in the form of Lord Nrisimhadeva tried many times to offer boons to to Prahlad, but Prahlad would always refuse them.
主 Vishnu 以主尼释迦戴的形象好几次试图给 Prahlad Maharaj 以祝福，但 Prahlad 都拒绝了。
Prahlad would never, he refused to ask to be liberated. The only thing he wanted was to be a pure devotee.
Prahlad 拒绝了解脱的赐福，他唯一要的就是纯粹的奉献服务。
So Lord Shiva says, I bow down before him.
主 Shiva 说，我在他面前向他致以顶拜。
So this shows the nature of Prahlad's devotion to the Supreme Lord.
这就展示了 Prahlad 对主的奉爱的本质。
Lord Nrisimhadev was trying to attract Prahlad Maharaj to get liberation, to ask for liberation. Just to let others see Prahlad's determination to stay fixed in pure devotion.
Nrisimhadev 试图让 Prahlad Maharaj 接受解脱的赐福，他只是为了让其他人看到 Prahlad 他有多么坚定的处在纯粹的奉爱之中。
So Lord Nrisimhadev ordered Prahlad Maharaj, he offered Prahlad Maharaj liberation many times.
主尼圣德夫有许多次都主动提出要给 Prahlad 解脱。
But Prahlad would only ask for pure devotion.
但是 Prahlad 只要向主要纯粹的奉爱。
Prahlad Maharaj wanted Prahlad just wanted that in his future births that he would always be engaged in the Lord's service.
Prahlad 希望在他将来的出生诞生当中他成为主的奉献者。
And Prahlad would pray to Lord Nrisimhadev. He prayed that, Oh Master, in all the thousands of births through which I must wander in this world, let me have unfailing devotion to you.
Prahlad 说，主人啊，在未来的我必须要在这个世界当中漫游，从而投生千万次，请让我对您拥有永不失败的奉爱。
So that shows that Prahlad was ready to take birth thousands of times in the material world. And he had no interest in liberation.
这表明 Prahlad 准备在这个物质世界投生千万次，但是他只要纯粹的奉爱。
So Lord Shiva describes, he says, Bali Maharaj violated the spiritual etiquette by disobeying the orders of his spiritual master.
主 Shiva 继续就说，巴利由于违背了他灵性导师的命令，从而逾越了灵性的仪轨。
And he even broke his own promises.
他甚至打破了自己的誓言。
But still, the Lord Vishnu, he agreed to become the guard at Bali Maharaj's door.
但是主仍然他同意成在巴利马哈拉的门前做他的守卫。
So some people may say that is the fruit of Bali's charity because Bali gives some charity to Lord Vamanadeva. So that is the result of the charity which he gave.
由于巴利玛拉诚心给主瓦曼纳德夫一些布施，有的人便说，那这个便是他的布施的一点结果。
And the Lord also granted protection to the wicked Banasura.
主还给这个邪恶的巴纳摩答应给他保护。
So was that the result of offering prayers to the Lord?
难道这便是我向主供奉祷文的结果吗？
我有啲钱咪同我，咁讲下，俾咗我啲钱咪同我钱咯。
我系，
你都系噶，你唔好
咁。系咁，我做嘢，你唔使俾我钱啊。
咁样就俾钱你，咁样我唔系俾钱你啊。啊，真系啊，你都冇俾钱你啊。
Can we mute the other people, please? Yeah, good. I'm muted. How do I unmute?
哈利奎什纳，不如请您自己再开一下麦，我刚才却挺静音了。
Okay, Isha, Mike, Mal, or the mic jump at all.
Maharaj, please unmute yourself.
I'm trying. What's young? Unmute. Okay. Chow Dala. Okay. Chow Dala. What job with Dala? Okay. So, because the personality of God had blessed Bali Maharaj by becoming his doorkeeper, so it suggests that Bali got more mercy than Prahlad Maharaj. But it said this is not true.That's not true. According to Lord Shiva, this is not true.
按照主 Shiva 的意见，这句话呢，这种结论并不是真的。
Lord Vishnu was favorable to Bali only because Bali was Prahlad's grandson.
主维什努之所以对巴利玛尔这么恩宠，只是由于巴利是普拉德的孙子。
And Bali had fought for the demons against the demigods.
巴利曾经为了恶魔的利益而与半神人们作战。
And Lord Brahma had set the condition that the demigods should rule, that they should rule heaven.
主 Brahma 说，半神人们应当由半神来统治天堂。
And the demons, they should be in the lower region in the universe, in the subterranean Patala Loka.
而恶魔们的领域应当是在宇宙当中比较低的 Patala Loka.
But Bali broke that rule. He changed it all around.
但是巴利就打破了这个规则。
Bali with the army of the demons invaded heaven. What? Invaded heaven and he took the throne. They invaded heaven and took the throne of Indra.
巴利就率领了恶魔们入侵了天堂，并且。就颠覆了 Indra 的统治。
And they gave the positions of the demigods, but positions which were supposed to be occupied by demigods, they gave them to demons.
他把本来应该属于半神人的地位呢，给予了这些恶魔。
So Bali did all these things. He broke all the laws which Brahma had set.
所以巴利。他已经违背了 Brahma 的这些意志，他做了这些不好的行为。
And Bali disobeyed the order given by his spiritual master Sukracharya.
巴利还违抗了他的领导是 Sukracharya 给他特殊信誉。
Sukracharya warned Bali not to give anything to Vamanadeva.
Shukracharya 警告巴黎不要给 Vamanadeva 任何的布施。
Even Bali had offered Lord Vamanadeva his choice of gifts in charity.
即便巴黎曾经给予主 Vamanadeva 他所选择的布施的礼物。
So he denied his spiritual, he disobeyed his spiritual master's orders. It's a serious crime.
由于他违背拒绝不执行他灵性老师的命令，所以这便是一个严重的罪恶。
So because he did that, he got cursed by his guru, Shukracharya.
正是由于他的这种行为，便遭到他
Shukracharya, inspired by the Supreme Lord, cursed Bali Maharaj.
在至尊主的激励下 ，Shukracharya 诅咒了 Bali Maharaj.
And even though Bali Maharaj was fixed in truth, but instead of respecting the spiritual master's instructions, he disobeyed them.
尽管巴利玛拉是文处在真理当中，但是他并没有尊重灵导师的训示，反而违抗了这些训示。
So because he agreed to give Lord Vamanadeva what he had asked for, his guru cursed him.
由于他答应给主 Vamanadeva 他所要求的布施，因此遭到了诅咒。
And Bali could not even provide.The charity he had offered Vamanadeva.
Bali 甚至无法实现他给主 Vamanadeva 要求的布施的誓言。
Can we mute everyone again?
Pardon, Mukiman, 我们再把所有人静音一下。
Okay.Am I muted? Are you okay? Can you hear me?
Yes, Maharaj, we can hear you.
Okay, so Vamanadeva wanted, he was supposed to get charity, he was supposed to get 3 steps of land, but he covered the universe with 2 steps.
主 Vamanadeva 本来应当得到三步土地的布施，但是他只用两个步伐间便包含了整个的宇宙。
And there was no land left for him to take the 3rd step.
那么他的第三步便没有任何土地可以使他踏出他的第三步。
So he was promising charity, but he couldn't keep his promise.
巴利呢他答应给予布施，但是他甚至无法实现这个诺言。
He had told Lord Vamanadeva, he told him, it appears that you have come here to ask me for something.
Bali 告诉主，表面上你到我这里来是要寻求一些事物。
So whatever you want, you can take from me.
那无论你想要什么，你都可以从我这里拿走。
You're a Brahmana, so you're worshipable.
因为你是婆罗门，因此值得人们尊敬。
So you could take from me, you can take a cow, you can have gold, you can have horses, elephants, chariots, a furnished house, villages, palatable food and drink, the daughter of a Brahmana for your own wife, or whatever you desire.
你可以向我索求一头母牛、黄金、马匹、大象、战车，装饰着家具的房子，或者是一个繁荣的村庄，可口的食物和饮料，或者是婆罗门的女儿作为您的妻子，无论你想要什么。
So when Lord Vamanadeva requested only 3 steps of land, that seemed too modest, and Bali laughed.
而当 Vamanadeva 呢， 只所求三部土地的布施的时候呢，这个要求似乎是非常微渺小的，所以使得巴利马拉就笑了。
Bali Maharaj said to Vamana Dev that your instructions are as good as those of learned and elderly persons.
他说你的训示呢，就和那些博学以及年长的人们的训示一样好。
But you're just a boy. Your intelligence is not enough.
但你只是个小男孩而已，您的智慧不足。
You're not thinking about your own self-interest.
你没有考虑到自己的利益。
So then Vamana Dev insisted that he didn't want anything more. He just wanted three steps of land.
但是 Vamana Dev 要求坚持说他别无所求，只要三步土地的布施。
So when Bali Maharaj heard that, then Bali Maharaj said,Bali Maharaj said, all right, take whatever you like.
当主说完这番话之后呢，巴利马拉就回答说，那好吧，你就无论你想要什么你就拿去吧。
But when Lord Vamana Dev took everything with two steps of land, they saw it's impossible to keep the promise which he'd given.
但是当 Vamana Dev 拿走了，只用两步便拿走了他想要的所有的事物的时候，甚至那么看上去巴利马拉是无法实现他的诺言。
So Bali Maharaj felt ashamed that he'd given his promise and he couldn't keep it.
巴利马拉因为自己曾经许下诺言却无法践行诺言而感到羞愧。
Actually, Bali didn't give away anything very important. He just gave away the insignificant three material worlds.
事实上呢，巴利并没有给予任何重要的什么重要的礼物，他只是给了微不足道的三个物质世界。
And he gave also his own body away.
他也把自己的躯体也献了出去。
And he told him,Take your third step on my head.
他告诉 Vamana Dev, 请您把您的第三步放在我的头顶。
So Lord Vamana Dev becoming Bali's doorkeeper couldn't have been the result of just the charity which Bali Maharaj gave.
Vamana Dev 之所以成为巴利的守门人，这不可能是只是由于巴利的微不足道的布施而使他成了守门人。
The Lord Vamana Dev must have reciprocated with Bali, because Bali's grandfather, is Prahlad Maharaj, and Prahlad Maharaj was a great soul, a great devotee of Vishnu.
主法曼德夫之所以和巴利以这种方式互动，是由于巴利的祖父就是普拉德，而普拉德是主的伟大的，是一个伟大的灵魂和亲爱的奉献者。
So Bali didn't deserve this benediction because he broke the rules of the universe.
巴利本来是不配得到这种祝福的，因为他已经打破了宇宙的秩序。
And he disobeyed the orders of his guru, and he broke his own promise.
他违抗了灵性导师的命令，也打破了自己的誓言。
So we can see in the ordinary world that as a general rule,Nothing substantial can be obtained. In exchange for something which has no value, you cannot expect to get anything of value. If you give away something which is not very valuable, you won't get anything very valuable.
我们看到呢，一般在世上的规则就是，如果你给出的事物并没有价值的话，那你得到的也不应该是非常有价值的事物。
I mean, Bali gave charity, but his charity was very small. He didn't give very much. He just gave the three worlds.
Bali 给出了布施，但这种布施呢，只是非常微不足道的，因为他给出的是物质世界。
So you cannot expect that he could purchase the personality of Godhead.
所以你不能指望呢，他借此就购买了、收买了至尊性格神手。
Personality of Godhead has a form of eternity, bliss, and knowledge.
至尊性格神手拥有永恒知识和极乐的身体。
So that charity could not result in Lord Vamanadeva entering into Bali's house as the doorkeeper.
这种布施的不应该成为主瓦玛德夫进入巴里马拉什的房子当了他的守门人。
The only good reason for Bali's good fortune to get the Lord as his doorkeeper was because of his connection with Prahlad Maharaj.
之所以巴里马拉什得到了这种主成为他守门人的好运，只是由于他和 Prahlad Maharaj 之间有关系。
And Prahlad Maharaj, he is the prima bhakta. He has prima for the Supreme Lord.
Prahlad Maharaj 是 prima bhakta, 他是至尊主的奉献者。
So because he's such a great devotee, so that was the mercy, brought mercy on Bali Maharaj.
由于他是这么伟大的奉献者，使得巴里马拉什也因此得到了好运。
So sometimes somebody may want to defend Bali Maharaj, and they may argue that some of the statements in the scriptures that Prahlad had blessed Bali with the gift of pure devotion.
有的人就试图捍卫巴利马拉什，说他是得到了普拉德马拉什的祝福。
Yeah, they got pure devotion from him.
巴利从普拉德那里得到了纯粹的奉爱之情。
And because he had that devotion, he achieved the Lord. He got the Lord to come there to his house to take care of the, to be his doorkeeper.
由于巴利内心的这种纯粹的奉爱，使得主来到他的房子，当了他的守门人。
And there's another example also given here about mentions about Banasura, who was a much more wicked person.
在这里举出了另外一个例子，就是邪恶的巴纳苏拉。
So.The Lord Vishnu is very compassionate to Prahlad Maharaj.
主对 Prahlad Maharaj 心怀怜悯。
But there's no reason why he would be compassionate to Bana. Bana's a demon.
但是主对 Bana 是如此这样的有怜悯之情，这是没有道理的，因为 Bana 是个恶魔。
Not even Lord Shiva could stop. Lord Shiva, he's a friend of Bana. Bana is a great devotee of Lord Shiva. But Lord Shiva couldn't save Bana when Krishna was about to kill him.
Bana 魔是主 Shiva 的奉献者，主 Shiva 是他的朋友。但是尽管如此，当 Krishna 打算杀死 Bana 的时候， Shiva 也救不了 Bana 的命。
And Bana, Lord Krishna was about to kill him, but Bana, he had many arms, he had 1,000 arms. So Lord Krishna cut off all of his arms and left him with 4 arms.
主 Krishna 就本来打算杀死巴纳， 巴那他有上千条臂膀，最后主 Krishna 把这些臂膀一一的砍掉，只给他留了四条臂膀。
And Lord Krishna also gave a benediction that Bana would always be Lord Shiva's eternal associate.
主 Krishna 也祝福巴那摩成为主 Shiva 的永恒的同游。
So Bana was so wicked that he even dared challenge Lord Shiva, who was, he was supposed to worship Lord Shiva, but he was such a wicked person that he even challenged Lord Shiva.
巴那摩是如此的 心肠邪恶，他胆敢挑战主 Shiva， 他所崇拜的对象。
It stated how Bana prayed to Lord Shiva.
这里就写到了巴那是如何向主 Shiva 先生祈祷。
Bana said to Lord Shiva, he said, I bow down to you, the spiritual master and controller of the worlds.
巴那祈祷说，我向你顶拜，你是三个世界的灵性导师和控制者。
You're like the heavenly tree that fulfills the desires of those whose desires are unfulfilled.
对于那些愿望没有得以实现的人们而言，你就好比天堂的能如愿树。
And you gave me the benediction to have 1,000 arms.
你祝福我，有一千条臂膀。
But these 1,000 arms have become a heavy burden for me.
但这上千个臂膀对我而言变成了一个重负。
I think you're the only one in the three worlds who can give me a good fight.
我认为在这个三个世界，只有你才能与我很好的酣战一场。
So.This is how Bana is speaking to his guru like this.
Bana 就跟他的 guru 这样说话。
Bana had also given up his devotion to Lord Vishnu.
Bana 也放弃了对主 Vishnu 的奉爱。
Actually, all the family of Bana, they were all devotees, but Bana gave up his devotion.
Bana 的家族都是主 Vishnu 的奉献者，但他却放弃了这种奉爱。
Instead, he became the enemy of all the Vaishnavas and the demigods and the Brahmanas.
相反，他变成了 Vaishnava 半身人和婆罗门的敌人。
So that's the nature of the demons. They're like that.
所以恶魔便本性如此。
He even arrested Lord Krishna's grandson Aniruddha, and he fought against Krishna.
他和主 Krishna 的孙子 Aniruddha， 他逮捕了主 Krishna 的孙子 Aniruddha， 并且和 Krishna 作战。
So that's described in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, how Aniruddha had a love affair with Banasura's daughter.
在圣典博迦瓦坛的第十篇当中描述说，巴那苏拉的女儿和 Krishna 的孙子，巴那的女儿和 Krishna
的孙子，
Krishna 的儿子就是有了那个恋情，
不是儿子是孙子 Aniruddha
的 grandson。那跟 Krishna 的孙子有了恋情。
Aniruddha. The son was Prajumna, and the grandson, Aniruddha.
孙子是 Aniruddha, 儿子是 Prajumna.
So Bana arrested Aniruddha.
所以 Bana 就逮捕了 Aniruddha.
And then Krishna had to come to get Aniruddha free.And there was a big fight between Banasura's army and Krishna's army.
Krishna 不得不过来营救Aniruddha, 并且和巴那摩的军队展开了作战。
At that time, Krishna cut off the arms of Banasura and left him with 4 arms.
就在这个战争当中 ，Krishna 砍掉了 Banasura 的 臂膀只给他留下了四条。
But he didn't kill Banasura. He told Banasura, "You will always be the servant of Lord Shiva."
但他并没有取巴纳苏尔摩的性命。他告诉巴纳摩，你将成为主 Shiva 的奉献者。
So Lord Shiva is asking, was it because of my prayers that Lord Krishna forgave Banasura for all his nonsense, for all his foolishness?
主 Shiva 就问，反问道，难道是由于我的祈祷才使得主原谅了巴纳苏惹他的所有这些恶行吗？
But it wasn't just because of Lord Shiva's prayers.
但这并不仅仅是由于主 Shiva 的祈祷。
It was only because of Prahlad's pure devotion.
这只是因为 Prahlad 的纯粹的奉爱。
Offenses against the devotees, just like Bana committed,can be removed only by the mercy of a Vaishnava.
像巴纳摩所做出的种种的冒犯，只能因为 Vaishnava 的仁慈而得到移除。
So it was only by Prahlad's grace that his grandson Bali and great grandson Bana were dealt with by the Lord.
仅仅是由于布拉德的仁慈，他使得他的孙子巴里和他的曾孙巴纳摩，得到了主的友好的对待。
And so Krishna pardoned them for their offense, and he elevated them. He elevated them, and elevated them.Krishna forgave them for their offenses and elevated them to please Prahlad.
主所以主便原宽恕了他们的冒犯，并且将他们提升，来取悦 Prahlad.
So in both the cases, that means Bana and Bali.Krishna or Lord Vamanadeva acted out of affection for Prahlad Maharaj.
所以在对待巴里和巴纳摩这两件事情当中，主都是出于对 Prahlad 的喜爱，他才采取了这些行为。
Prahlad is the most beloved devotee of Lord Vishnu.
Prahlad 是主 Vishnu.最钟爱的奉献者。
But Lord Shiva said, "I can't say any more about this because of the presence of my good wife Gauri is present, and she's the close friend of the goddess of fortune Lakshmi."
但是主 Shiva 说，在对此呢，我不能再进一步的深入的再说了，因为我现在就在 Gauri 面前，而 Gauri 是 Lakshmi 女神的好朋友。
Yeah, Narada would like to hear more about Prahlad Maharaj, but Lord Shiva is afraid to speak more.
Narada 想要进一步聆听 Prahlad 的荣耀，但是主 Shiva 不敢再继续说了。
Lord Shiva is worried that.He might make his wife angry.
主 Shiva 担心会使自己的妻子不高兴。
Lord Shiva thinks if I talk more about Prahlad Maharaj praising Prahlad Maharaj, he will become ecstatic. He'll become too ecstatic.
如果主 Shiva 再进一步赞扬 Prahlad 的话，那么他无疑他就会陷入狂喜。
And then if he speaks too loudly, then Parvati may hear what he's saying.
如果主 Shiva 声音太高声的来说的话， Parvati 就可能听到他在说什么。
And she is a good friend of Mahalakshmi.
Parvati 是 Mahalakshmi 的好朋友。
And she wouldn't like to hear about Prahlad being a greater devotee than the concert of the Supreme Lord.
他可不喜欢听到说普拉德甚至比主至尊主的伴侣他的地位还要伟大。
If Parvati becomes annoyed, Lord Shiva worries she will not act respectfully towards him and Narada, and that would not be good for her.
如果 Parvati 他变得恼怒起来的话，主 Shiva 担心他就会对他本人以及 Narada 就做出不尊敬的行为，而这对他本人对 Parvati 是不好的。
So somebody new in devotional service like Prahlad, you know, because they're thinking that Prahlad is just new in devotional service. So how could he be a better devotee than Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune?
根据有些人的观点，普拉德他在奉爱服务当中只是一个新人而已，他怎么可能超越幸运女神
？Yeah, Lakshmi, she resides eternally on the chest of Lord Narayan.
幸运女神 Lakshmi 永恒的居住在主 Narayan 的胸膛。
But Prahlad also got special mercy from the Lord to put him in that very big position as a great devotee.
但是普拉德也得到了主的特殊的仁慈，使得他拥有占据了这样一个伟大的地位。
When Brahma gave Aranyakashipu the boon that made him the caused him to give so much trouble in the three worlds, at that time the Supreme Lord was concerned that his devotees not have confidence in devotional service.
当恶魔毗沙迦喀什布得到了Brahma 的祝福的时候，他之后给这个世界带来了麻烦。这时候主便担心他的奉献者在奉爱服务当中没有充分的信心。
Yeah, they may lose their confidence in devotional service because they will see their enemy.Allowed to become so powerful, the enemy meaning Aranyakashipu becoming so powerful.
当他们看到他们的敌人毗沙迦喀什布变得如此强大有力的时候，他们可能在奉爱服务当中的信心便削弱了。
So to help get rid of the Vaishnavas' doubts and their anxiety, Lord Nrisingadev, right after killing Aranyakashipu.He blessed Prahlad.
所以为了帮助驱除 Vaishnava 的焦虑和疑惑，主尼辛和 Dave 在杀死毗沙迦喀什布之后祝福了 Prahlad.
He blessed Prahlad to become greater than all other devotees, past and present.
他祝福 Prahlad.比所有其他的奉献者，过去的奉献者以及当下现在的奉献者都要伟大。
And he would be greater than all the residents of Vaikuntha.
Prahlad 会比 Vaikuntha 的居民还要伟大。
And his personal attendants and his.Beloved consort Lakshmi, Prahlad will be greater than all of them.
Prahlad 甚至要比主的私人的仆人和他亲爱的伴侣 Lakshmi 还要伟大。
And so Lord Shiva knew about this, and Lord Shiva said, "There's a great personality receiving Krishna's mercy, greater than your father, me."And other servants as well, greater than other servants like Garuda.
Shiva 说，他知道这一点，所以说，在，就是有一个主 Krishna 的更 伟大的仁慈的接受者，他超过了你的父亲、我还有其他的仆人，例如 Garuda。
And even greater than the goddess of fortune is this devotee, and this devotee's name is Prahlad.
他甚至超过了他的伟大之处，超过了幸运女神，他的名字就是 Prahlad.
And he's famous. He's famous throughout the world as the dearmost devotee of Krishna.
全世界，在他的名声。享誉了全世界，他就是主 Krishna 最亲爱的奉献者。
When Lord Nrisimhadev tore apart Hiranyakashipu, at that time, Lord Shiva said, "I and all the demigods and the goddess of fortune worship the Lord with our we witnessed with our own eyes the good fortune of Prahlad."
主释迦说，当主撕开毗然要喀什普的胸膛的时候，我所有的半神人们，甚至幸运女神拉克什米都亲眼目睹了 Prahlad 的无与伦比的好运。
So Prahlad became the greatest Vaishnava, which would otherwise have been impossible.
Prahlad 便成为最伟大了不起的 Vaishnava。否则的话，如果没有这个祝福，它是不可能的。
Sometimes Krishna may say that other devotees like Prahlad are dearer to him.Than Lord Sankarshan, and dearer to him than Mahalakshmi, and even dearer to him than other great personalities.
有时候，人格守神会宣布，像 Prahlad 对于他的亲切程度超过了主 Sankarshan 呢 ，Mahalakshmi 和其他伟大的人物。
And Prahlad is a devotee, he's greater than even the residents of Vaikuntha.
Prahlad, he 甚至比 Vaikuntha 的居民还要伟大。
Not even Lord Brahma or Lord Shiva or Lord Sankarshan or the goddess of fortune. And Krishna said, not even myself is as dear to me as Prahlad is to me.
主说，无论主 Brahma、主 Shiva、主 Sankarshan 的幸运的神，甚至我本人都不如你，那样对我那么亲切。
And Lord Narayan also tells the same thing to Durvasa Muni.
主 Narayan 也这样对 Durvasa Muni 说。
He says that without saintly persons, he said, I am not attracted to my own self or to my spiritual consort, the goddess of fortune, Sri.
主说，没有这些圣人们，那么我对，我自己甚至对我的超然的伴侣，幸运女神 Sri 都没有什么吸引力了。
So the Lord has eternal associates. His eternal associates are people like Sankarshan and Mahalakshmi and so on.
主他有他永恒的同游 Sankarshan, Mahalakshmi 等等。
So although he has these people who are his eternal associates, and they're very great devotees, and they.But whenever the new devotees in the material world come before the Lord, then the Lord appreciates them more than these other eternal associates.
尽管主拥有永恒的同游，但是当物质世界有新奉献者来到他面前的时候，那么这位新奉献者比他的同游对他还要钟爱。
These new devotees, they undergo a lot of trouble. They suffer a lot to get the position of complete devotion to the Lord.
这些所谓的新奉献者，他们在物质世界，他们做出了种种的牺牲，他们受了很多的苦才达到这种地位。
And they sacrifice all the comforts and all the security just to get pure devotional service.
他们牺牲了所有的舒适和安全感，只是为了获得纯粹的奉献服务。
So because these new devotees take so much trouble, Lord Krishna is very grateful to them.
由于这些新奉献者经历了种种的麻烦，使得主便对他们特别感激。
So the Lord wants to encourage all the devotees to surrender.
主希望来鼓励他的奉献者们向他臣服。
And he wants them to surrender more fully. And to get them to surrender more fully, he also praises devotees like Prahlad Maharaj, who have taken so many risks for the service of the Lord.
为了鼓励这些奉献者充分的、更完全的向他臣服，主便赞扬了 Prahlad 这样的奉献者。 Prahlad 为了取悦主、满足主，冒了种种的巨大危险。
So we may wonder, how could Prahlad be greater than Brahma and Indra and other demigods?
我们可能会纳闷， Prahlad 怎么可能比 Brahma、Indra 和其他半神还要伟大呢？
The demigods are often able to have the audience of Lord Vishnu.
半神人们可以经常的得见主威士努。
And that's the perfection of all spiritual practice, to be able to meet directly the Lord.
能够直接的面见主，这是所有的灵性修习的完美。
But Prahlad, he doesn't get that. He associates with the Lord. He associates with the Lord just by remembering him.
但是普拉德没有得到这样的面对面见到主，他是通过意念主恒常大部分时候和主联谊的。
And Prahlad himself will say so in the next chapter.
普拉德本人将在下一章他会表述这一点。
Prahlad will say, I never performed any real service for the Lord like Hanuman and others.
普拉德说，我从来没有像哈努曼和其他人那样为主做过什么真正的服务。
I've only remembered the Lord sometimes.
我只是有些时间意念想起主。
Like when my mind is troubled, then I remember the Lord.
当我心烦意乱的时候，我就想起主。
But we should remember, Prahlad, he does see the Lord constantly.
但是我们应当记住 Prahlad 实际上恒常的在见到了主。
And it's described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the fifth canto, that Prahlad offers his prayers on the planet Harivarsha.
根据圣典博迦瓦坛第五篇第十八章，普拉德在哈瑞瓦沙这个星球上不断的向主献上祈祷。
And Prahlad's grandson Bali has also inherited from him the right to see the Lord constantly.
Prahlad 的孙子巴里也继承了Prahlad。
So the Lord stays with him in the form of Vamanadev.
所以主就以 Vamanadev 的形象呢和巴利恒常的在一起。
Lord Vamanadev stays in the palace of Bali Maharaj.
主 Vamanadev 就待在巴利的宫殿。
So Prahlad may criticize himself because he's only able to remember the Lord and not actually see him directly.
Prahlad 也许呢自责，他只能意念主，而不能直接的见到主。
So that is just Prahlad's humility.
这只是 Prahlad 的谦卑而已。
Because he's a perfect Vaishnava, so the perfect Vaishnava, they're very humble like that.
Prahlad 是完美的 Vaishnava, 所以他们就会非常谦卑。
And whatever Prahlad says about himself, Prahlad is dearer to the Supreme Lord than even the Lord's eternal associates in Vaikuntha.
无论的 Prahlad 是怎对自己是怎样的评价，他对于至尊主的亲切程度超过了主在 Vaikuntha 的永恒同游们。
And the reason he became endowed with such pure devotion was that Lord Shiva gave him certain instructions. Narada gave him certain instructions when he was still in the womb.
Prahlad 之所以能变得如此的稳处在父爱中，是因为他还在他母亲的子宫的时候就得到了纳尔德的训示。
So he was born a pure devotee, and you deserve to be awarded with happiness in the future.
Prahlad 一出生就是纯粹的奉献者。并且 Prahlad 值得拥有在将来拥有快乐。
Okay, so maybe we stop here today.
好，那我们现在就停到这里，看一下问题。第一个是昨天晚上的问题，来自于维慧，顶拜咕噜。夏天蚊虫苍蝇也不能伤害，对吗？
Yes, 不能伤害。
是的，不能伤害。
Yeah, we respect life in all living entities.
我们尊重在所有生命种族当中的，在所有的生命种类。
So,If there's some creatures you don't want in the house, you can put them outside.
如果你不希望这些生物体在你自己的房子里的时候，你可以把它们以某种方式放在外面。
Keep them outside.
把它们赶出去。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于古嘉林，当有人不小心打碎了神像用品，除了顶拜，重新买一个就可以了吗？会有冒犯吗
？Well, if they broke it deliberately, then it's an offense. But if it's an accident, then it's
如果他们是有意的打破了，那就是冒犯。如果是意外打破了，那就不算。
Yeah, you should be careful with the deity paraphernalia.
所以在对待神像的随身用品的时候呢，要很小心。
What did she break? What was it?
古嘉林，您打破的是什么呢？那您能写一下您 打破的是什么吗？那您要不然开麦，您就打破了是什么？要先休息。
Okay.
他不在 ，she's not here.
Okay, we'll go ahead.
下一个是来自于 Harini， 顶拜孤的莲花族，曾经有资深奉献者告诉我，我们可以在神像跟前哭泣，并向主倾诉自己的痛苦。那我昨晚没听明白，我们在神像面前哭泣是不吉祥的，还是对主的冒犯呢？
But crying in front of the deities, is it an offense?
We confide ourselves about our
confide ourselves.
We told the Lord about our painful condition in front of the Lord, in front of the deity. Some senior devotee told me we can shed tears in front of the deity and to told Lord about our pain in our heart. But yesterday night you said,In the lecture, it said it's an inauspicious to cry in front of a deity.
Yes, we shouldn't cry in front of the deity. But if you're going to talk to the deity, that's a different thing.
是的，我们不应该在神像面前哭泣。但是如果您只是跟神像交谈，那就不一样了。
If you're going to tell Krishna all your difficulties, you can do that.
如果您想和 Krishna 倾诉种种的困难，您可以这样去倾诉。
But you should know, Krishna knows all your difficulties.
但是您当明白 ，Krishna 了解您的困境。
Anyway, if you feel better by talking to Krishna, then you can.
无论如何，如果您和 Krishna 交流了之后，您感觉好多了，您可以这样去做。
But try to give Krishna good news. Don't just tell him all the bad news.
但是要努力的给 Krishna 告诉 Krishna 好消息，不要一到 Krishna 面前就说的都是坏消息。
When you come to Krishna, don't just only come to ask to take from Krishna. We should give thanks to Krishna. We should say thank you, Krishna.
不要一到 Krishna 面前就想着向 Krishna 那里得到什么，反而我们当感谢 Krishna。下一个是 Pancha Tatva Prabhu， 顶拜 Maharaj 主持人 ，Sukracharya 诅咒了巴利，那对现在的奉献者，从这件事儿，对奉献者有什么启示呢？对现今的奉献者
有什么启示？
What's the revelation to devotee from this event? What's the lessons we can learn
from which event we're talking about?
Shukracharya cursed Bali Maharaj.
Yeah. Well, we should understand that the importance of following the orders of the spiritual teacher.
那我们就应当明白遵守灵性导师的命令是多么重要。
Of course, Shukracharya, he was not actually the bona fide guru. He was giving instructions which were against devotional service.
当然 ，Shukracharya 不是一个正宗的 guru， 他给出的训示是违背了，就是反对纯粹的奉爱服务。
So first thing is you have to be very careful about selecting a spiritual master.
第一件事就是我们在选择灵性导师的这件事情上一定要非常的谨慎。
And once you select a spiritual master, then we should faithfully carry out the orders of the spiritual master.
一旦选定了灵性导师之后，我们就要忠心耿耿地执行灵性导师的命令了。
Now in Bali Maharaj's case, he disobeyed the orders of the spiritual master for a higher purpose.
在巴利马拉吉这件事情上，他之所以违背灵性导师的命令是，为了达到一个更高的目标。
He wants to bring, he wants to do devotional service. He understands that Lord Vishnu, that Lord Vamanadeva is Lord Vishnu.And he feels that, well, if he is Lord Vishnu, he could take everything from me, so it's better I give it rather than have him take it.
那么他为了做奉爱服务，他明白瓦曼德夫就是 Vishnu 本人。如果他确实是 Vishnu 本人的话，他会拿走一切的。那么与其让他拿走一切，还不如我主动献出来呢。
So you can see the spiritual master like Shukracharya, he gave instructions which were against the principles of devotional service.
我们看到像 Shukracharya 这样的灵性导师给予门徒的训示是违背了奉爱服务的原则。
So that's, if you take such a person as your spiritual master, that's very dangerous.
谁要是接受了这样的灵性导师，就是非常危险的。
And the fact that Shukracharya cursed Bali Maharaj, you could say that curse actually was like a blessing for Bali Maharaj.
Shukracharya 他对巴利的诅咒，可以说成是实际上是对巴利玛拉的祝福。
Because the result was that Lord Vamanadeva went there with Bali Maharaj to reside in the kingdom of Bali Maharaj.
因为这个诅咒，结果呢，瓦曼德夫就和巴利玛拉一起就居住在他的国度。
So you have to be very careful in selecting the guru.
因此，人们在选择灵性guru入这件事情上一定要小心。
And Bali Maharaj, he saw that his guru was deviating. He gave up his guru. He stopped following the instruction.
当巴利玛拉看到他的guru已经走偏了、背离的时候，他就放弃了他的guru。没有听从 guru 的话。
Because he saw his guru was he was saying one thing, and then he was saying a different thing. He was giving contradictory instructions.
巴里看到呢，他的 guru 呢，他某一时间说的是一种话，换一时间呢，他说的是另一种话。他的训示是相互矛盾的。
So Shukracharya was telling him in the beginning, he was saying, give charity to the brahmanas, give everything to Vishnu.
一开始 Shukracharya 的训示是要给婆罗门布施，要布施给 Vishnu.
And then when Lord Vamanadeva came there to get the charity, then Shukracharya said, don't give him.
但是当瓦玛拉德夫来到现场想要得到布施的时候，舒克扎尔却命令说不要给他。
Okay, so you, that kind of guru, you know, you have to give them up.
这种 guru 就应当放弃。
Okay.
下一个是 Yuvati Sachi David Dasi. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances as all glory to Srila Prabhupada. In Bhagavad Gita 4, chapter 4, verse 37, Srila Prabhupada says in purport, when one is in complete knowledge, all reactions, both the prior and the posterior, are consumed. Question, what is perfect knowledge? Thank you so much for your wonderful lecture, wonderful class.
What is perfect knowledge? Well, perfect knowledge is knowledge of the Supreme Lord.
完美的知识就是有关于至尊主的知识。
And our relationship with him.
以及我们和至尊主之间的关系的知识。
Perfect knowledge means knowledge of the Supreme Lord and his energies.
完美的知识就是有关于至尊主和至尊主的能量的知识。
So we get this perfect knowledge from our books, from Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们从圣典不加梵歌、圣典不加瓦坛这些书籍当中得到这样的知识。
嗯哼。
好，下一个是 Dina Tarini David Dasi。Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Maharaj 的莲花族，顶拜奉献者们，请教 Guru Maharaj, 如果给予了其他人错误的指导，使其他人从事了罪恶的活动，因此带来的罪恶反应是谁来承担？只是指导者还是被指导者，还是两个人都需要承担？只是承担的比例不同，指导者承担的多一点，被指导者承担的少一点呢？谢谢 Maharaj。
Who takes the reactions for the sins?
Yes.
Yeah, you better translate it for me.
Yeah, okay. Dina Tarini asked that if one gives others not incorrect direction so that the others has committed sin, then who should take the reaction of sinful reaction? Is that the director or the person who is being directed, or both have to share the sinful reaction according to different percentages, and the director should take more than the person who is being directed? Thank you.
Well, it depends on the relationship. Just like if someone is, if you know, if you're the disciple of the spiritual master, and the spiritual master gives you the instruction, so if you follow the instruction of the spiritual master, you're acting under the authority of the spiritual master. So if the instruction is wrong, the spiritual master should take the reactions, not the disciple.
这是取决于关系，他们指导者和被指导者二人的关系。倘若是guru和门徒的关系的话，就是门徒应当遵守灵性导师的训示，门徒应当在灵性导师的指导之下，在这个权威的指导之下来活动。结果呢，灵性导师给出了错误的指导，导致了门徒做了不好的行为。在这种情况下，应当是由灵性导师来承担这个业报反应，而不是门徒来承担。
But disciple also should be intelligent enough to understand if something is wrong.
他但是呢，如果是有不对的地方，门徒他应当有足够的智慧能够辨别。
You know, if some authority, if somebody who's our authority is doing something which we know is definitely wrong, then we shouldn't follow. We're not obliged to follow.
如果就是我们的权威，我们明明知道我们的权威他是错误的，那我们就没有义务一定要遵守这个权威的话。
So you have to be careful.
Yeah. 要小心。
You have to use your intelligence. You have to understand what is being asked of us. What if we're told to do something? Then you should think carefully.
我们要运用我们的智性，倘若有人对我们做出了要求，告诉我们做某件事情的话，那我们要三思而后行。
We have to pray to Krishna to give us good intelligence to understand how to properly act.
你要向 Krishna 祈祷，请求 Krishna 给予我们正确的智慧，来采取正确的行为。
We shouldn't just be blind followers.
我们不应当做那盲目的追随者。
So we have to look and hear, see what we're doing, what's being asked of us, what we're being told to do.
我们应当就是仔细的审视这件事情，然后聆听，然后看看对我们的资格要求，还要告诉我们的要做的事情到底对不对。下一个是 Bhakti 严冰顶拜咕噜，请问从 Brahma 眉心产生的 Shiva 和创造维系毁灭中的 Shiva 有什么不同呢？
What about Shiva?
Yeah, she's asking that Shiva who is generated from the.Between the two eyebrows of Lord Shiva, what's the difference between Lord Shiva who is creating, maintain, and destroy, who is carrying out?
Well, the one who comes from the eyebrows, that's when Lord Shiva's angry, he's known as Rudra.
来自于 Brahma 眉心的那位 Shiva是when Brahma is angry, that right?
No. Oh yeah, Brahma's angry, yeah, yeah.
当 Brahma 生气愤怒的时候，就从他的眉心产生出 Shiva, 这位 Shiva, 这些 Shiva 是被称为是 Rudra.
Yeah, Rudra. Rudra, the Rudra. We talk about the Rudra principle. Sometimes we talk about the Rudra principle.Means people can get angry sometimes in different circumstances. They will become angry.
我们说到，也会有 Rudra 原则，就是人们在不同的情况之下，他们可能变得愤怒。
So, Lord Brahma was angry. He was controlling his anger, but it came out in the form of Lord Shiva.
主 Brahma 呢，他变得愤怒，然后他试图控制自己的愤怒，从他的眉心就诞生出 Rudra.
So that's Rudra, and then you have generally that's who we think of being as being Lord Shiva. We think that the one who's born from Brahma, the son of Brahma, is Lord Shiva. So that's Shiva in the material world.
通常呢，我们认为这个人物呢，就是主 Shiva 本人，他是 Brahma 的儿子，他。
Yeah.
He is in the material world.
Yeah.
他在物质世界。
But you have also, well, one Lord Shiva is a guna avatar, then he's empowered, in charge of the mode of ignorance.
主 Shiva， 当主 Shiva 他作为 Guna Avatar 就是品质的化身的角色的时候，他被给予力量来掌管愚昧属性。
嗯。So part of his duty as a Guna Avatar in charge of the mode of ignorance is to fulfill the work of destruction at the time of the end of the life of Brahma.
他作为品质化身的职责之一就是实现满，就实现他的这个使命，在 Brahma 寿命结束的时候，他施行毁灭。
So you've got Lord Shiva in these different ways. You've got Lord Shiva also in Kailash. Kailash is between the spiritual world and the material world.
还有在凯拉什山上的 Shiva， 那凯拉什呢是介于灵性世界、物世界之间。
So that's Lord Shiva's residence there, where he resides eternally.
这个是主 Shiva 永恒的居所。
But I'm not very clear about the different positions of Lord Shiva. We don't get a lot of information about which Shiva and this Shiva and that Shiva. It seems to be there are, for example, there's 9 Rudras.
但是呢，马尔说他对于主就是主 Shiva 的地位呢，也并不是特别的清楚，因为有关于主 Shiva 的信息，有各式各样的信息，这个 Shiva 那个 Shiva， 那好像是有九位 Rudra。
So which particular Rudra is doing the destruction? I don't know. One of them, one of the Shiva.
到底是哪一位 Rudra 他在执行毁灭呢？我也不知道，肯定是其中之一了。
We don't get a lot of information.
我们在这方面得到讯息并不是很多。
Okay.
好，下一个，还是八天阳兵顶拜 Guru Krishna 是绝对的。有些恶魔被 Krishna 直接杀死，回到 Goloka。仍然是极大的仁慈，而不够进步的奉献者都没有这种仁慈。怎么理解为了更接近 Krishna？ 怎么理解为了更接近 Krishna 反而去做恶魔呢？
So, to get near to Krishna, you have to become a demon. She's saying.
Maybe she's saying that in some cases, would rather to become demon to get close to Krishna because.
Well, that's not the point. You see, those are very special people, those demons who become, you know, you have to understand these demons are not ordinary people.
不应当这样理解，就是那些恶魔，他们是特例，他们不是普通人。
And somehow, you know, they come into Krishna's pastimes and they take this particular form and they become demons. Krishna kills them and then they get impersonal liberation.
他们来到参与 Krishna 的消时光，他们就是以这个恶魔形体来参加，然后被 Krishna 杀死，得到了非人格的解脱。
And some demons, they enter, they get impersonal liberation. Some demons even actually go back to Godhead. People like Putana, you know, Krishna took Putana into Goloka, although she came as a demon.
有的恶魔他甚至直接就去了Goloka, 就比如说恶魔女巫 Putana.
And then also Pondraka.Pundraka also got to go into the spiritual world. He got Swarupya Mukti,
还有 Pondraka 这个恶魔，他被杀死之后直接去了灵性世界，他得到了 Sarupya 解脱和主有同。
And also, Bakasuran. You know, some, there were different demons. Krishna killed them, but they got to go into the spiritual world. They didn't just get impersonal liberation.
还有像巴卡姆这样的恶魔，他们被杀死之后直接去灵性世界，并没有得到非人格的解脱。
So you have to understand these demons are very, they have some very special connection with Krishna somehow, that they come in Krishna's pastimes and they're playing these roles. But they're not ordinary. They're not just any ordinary soul. They have some special qualification. Otherwise, they could not be in Krishna's pastimes.
我们要明白呢，就是他们这样的恶魔呢和 Krishna 之间存在特殊的关系，他们具备特殊的资格才得以参加 Krishna 的逍遥时光，他们绝非普通的灵魂。
So anyway, we're encouraged not to become demons, we're encouraged to cultivate devotion.
无论如何并不是鼓励我们要成为恶魔，我们应当培养奉爱服务。
Yes, become a devotee.
我们当做奉献者。
And you can go back to Godhead, and you can have a loving relationship with Krishna.
您可以，就是和回到神手那里和 Krishna 有种爱的关系。
Okay.
下一个是 Shruti Rupa Devadasi， 顶拜 Guru 和老师们，请教 Guru 几个问题。第一个问题是，佛经详细描述了人因为各种罪恶，来生变成各种奇形怪状的业报身体。为什么在圣地会有那么多长得奇怪、长相奇怪又可怕的人呢？他们是业报。因为他们是因业报而来，还是半神化身的呢？
Wait, why are there so many demons in the holy places?
Not demon, but in the holy places, there are so many people whose looking are very strange and horrible.
Well, you cannot judge people just by your material vision.
就是您不能根据一个人的物质的长相来判定某个人。
Yeah, don't just look at, you know, their external appearance. You have to see their heart.
不要看一个人的外表，而要看一个人的内心。
So someone may look very frightening and terrifying. That's only to your vision.And someone else who knows them, they may be their friend.
有的人他看上去长相恐怖可怕，这只是您的视角，而另外一个认识他们的人可能就觉得他们特别友好。
So be careful about judging people just by their external appearance.
所以要小心，不要由于人的外貌来断定一个人。
We give the example about the Ganges water, the river Ganges. The water in the Ganges may appear to be full of bubbles and foam and mud, and we may think, oh, it's not very nice look. I don't know if I want to take bath there.
就有个例子，就好像恒河水啊，里面有泥泞泡沫，那我们看见了以后就想，哎呦，看上去不那么美好，我可不想在里面沐浴。
You have to be careful. The water of the Ganges is always pure. It may not look very pure, but it's always pure.
所以就要小心我们的嗜欲。恒河水看上去。不是那么纯净，但事实上恒河水是纯净的。
It comes from the lotus feet. It comes from the causal ocean, and it washes the lotus feet of Lord Brahmanadev.
恒河水来自于元婴之阳，并且洗涤过主 Vamanadeva 的莲花足。
So we bathe in the water without hesitation.
所以我们毫不犹豫的就在恒河水中沐浴。
Okay.
第二个问题是，我过去在灵性上很多不可能的祈祷，几乎都得到了回应和实现。为什么在物质上看来很简单的祈祷都不灵验呢？比如说，我想通过功利性活动来赚钱，就是不成功。
Let's translate.
Yeah, many in the past.Many impossible spiritual prayer have been fulfilled, but why very simple material prayer is not cannot be fulfilled? For example, I try to earn money by my karmic activity, but I cannot achieve success.
Well, you should understand there's a desire of the Supreme Lord.
那您当明白呢，至尊主他有他自己的意愿。
Don't just think of everything, don't think you should get everything your way. Lord Krishna is the Supreme Controller.
不要想着呢，就是一切都如你所愿，因为 Krishna 才是至尊主才是控制者。
So you, we say man proposes and God disposes.
有一句英语的谚语就叫谋事在人，成事在 Krishna.
So you have to understand what is Krishna's desire and you have to surrender to that.
你要明白 Krishna 的愿望是什么，然后向 Krishna 的愿望臣服。
So it's better to, maybe you have to not be so ambitious for material gains.
所以最好您还不如就不要就是在物质的得意上有野心勃勃的。
Krishna wants you to be more devotional and to be less fruitive.
Krishna 希望您更有奉爱之心，而比较少的有这种功利心。
OK。
第三个，相对于普拉达大军对主纯粹的奉爱，遭拒不父亲的暴行，我们作为普通人在奉爱成长中，自然也有意无意造成了对家人的物质服务和情感上的伤害。我们应该如何努力，才能？最大可能的平衡这一切，把真正的灵性利益带给亲人呢？深深顶拜 Guru Dev 的莲花足。Prahlad, due to his devotion to the Lord, his father has done something very terrible to him. As ordinary people, during our cultivation of devotion,there's something we have hurt, we have done something that harmful to the our family member, to their feeling, due to our material service, maybe unintentionally. So how can we try to balance all this and give them the real spiritual benefit?
Well, just by giving them that spiritual benefit, simply give them Krishna consciousness.
那您所要做的呢，就是仅仅去给予他们灵性的利益就好了，给予他们 Krishna 知觉。
You'll never satisfy people materially.
你永远不可能在物质上满足一个人。
There will always be difficulties in the material world.
在物质世界呢，永远都会有困难困境。
Just try to give people some Krishna consciousness.
你只要努力地去给予人们 Krishna 知觉。
It's very hard to try to always think you're thinking about the family members and you're thinking about this and that. Just try to think about, ultimately you should think about Krishna really. What is your duty as a spirit soul?
您不要总是想着家人呢、啊、想着这件事那件事什么的。您真正要练习的是 Krishna。您作为灵魂，您的灵性的职责是什么？
Life becomes very confusing when you're trying to satisfy so many people. You're thinking about their material needs, and then at the same time you're thinking about spirituality. It becomes very confusing.
当您试图满足这些人的物质需求的时候，同时也惦记着灵性的事情的时候，那您的生命啊，就变得有种种的困惑。
So try to be self-satisfied. Try to be happy in yourself.
你要努力变得自我满足，在自我当中快乐，寻求快乐。
In the mind, you're thinking about so many other things. You're thinking about your family members and this friend and that person.
您的心意里呢，充满着各种各样的事物。也有家人啊朋友啊这个那个的。
So you have to go, we say go with the flow, you know, do what has to be done, and at the same time keep yourself in Krishna consciousness. Try to keep your mind fixed on Krishna.
我们就通常会说顺其自然，就是您该做什么就做什么，同时呢要保持自己的 Krishna 知觉，心意要想着 Krishna。
Just try to depend on the Krishna for the results. And you do what you're supposed to do as a devotee, what you're supposed to do as a person, you know. Don't try to think about what they want. You have to think what ultimately you want to do, what's your goal, where are you trying to go?
你要依赖 Krishna, 来就是取得结果，就做你作为奉献者应尽的义务，然后呢，不要老想着别人的物质需求，你要想着自己的，锁定自己的目标，您自己想要去哪里。
Our life is very short. We don't have a long time in this material world.
生命非常短暂，我们在物质世界的寿命并不
很。
那您应该是，把分分秒秒都是最大的利，最合理的利用每分每一秒。
So try to keep yourself.Situated in Krishna consciousness.
努力的让你自己稳处在 Krishna 知觉当中。
Just do your regular hearing and chanting.
有规律的去聆听，有规律的念诵。
And be friendly and happy.
对别的生物都友好，并且你自己要。保持快乐。
Be satisfied in your own mind.
您的自己要让自己心意满足。
And that will have the best effect on everyone. If you're happy, if you're peaceful and satisfied, then it will help others also.
您这种状态才能最好的给别人带来最大的好处，就是您自己非常的平和。快乐满足自我满足快乐。
Okay.
Okay. servant, 下一个是来自于 servant。顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和奉献者们，感谢您，感谢您。请问 Mahalakshmi 幸运女神是专指主 Vishnu 的妻子，还是 Krishna 所有扩展和化身的妻子？都是幸运女神呢，包括 Dwarka 的16000个妻子。
Yes.
Thank you, Guru. Yes, thank you, Guru Maharaj and devotees. My question is that, Lakshmi, Mahalakshmi, the goddess of fortune, is specifically refers to the wife of Lord Vishnu, or refer to all the wives of Krishna's expansion and avatar, including his Krishna's wife, 10,108 wives. What does Mahalakshmi really refer to?
Mahalakshmi is the head of all the goddesses of fortune. She's the most senior. She's the direct consort of all of Krishna. And she's the one who resides on Lord Krishna's chest.
Mahalakshmi is 所有幸运女神的首领，他就是直接主的伴侣，他就是居住在主胸膛上的那一位。
Yeah, Mahalakshmi is the most senior of all. There's many goddesses of fortune, unlimited numbers of goddesses of fortune in the spiritual world, and all the gopis are also goddesses of fortune. But there's in Vaikuntha.There is the direct wife of Lord Narayan, and that's Mahalakshmi.
所有的就是那些年长的，不是 Mahalakshmi 是最年长的幸运女神，因为在灵性世界有无数的幸运女神，那些牧牛姑娘也是幸运女神。但是就是在 Vaikuntha 呢，只有一位是主，Narayan 的妻子。这位人物就是 Mahalakshmi。
Yeah. Okay.
下一个是，他们和 Radharani 是什么关系 ？What's the relation between those goddesses of fortune and Radharani?
Well, Radharani is the original. The original.Feminine form. She is the origin of all the goddesses of fortune. They're all coming from Srimati Radharani.
Srimati Radharani 呢，她是最原始的神的the original feminine form of Lord, right?
Yeah.
她是最原始的主的女性的形象。她是所有幸运女神的源头。
So, Srimati Radharani, she is one with Krishna, right? We say Radha and Krishna were originally one. Srimati Radharani, she is the pleasure energy of Lord Krishna in Goloka Vrindavan.
Radharani 和 Krishna, 他们是就是一位，他们原本是一位。Radharani 是 Krishna 在 Goloka Vrindavan 他是 Krishna 的快乐喜乐能量。
And Mahalakshmi, she's in Vaikuntha. She's the consort of the Lord in Vaikuntha.
而 Mahalakshmi 呢，她是居住在 Vaikuntha， 她是主在 Vaikuntha 的伴侣。
Okay.
Yes. Thank you.下一个是 servant， 请教 Guru Maharaj， 以往很多旧挂历有主的画像怎么处理 ？How to deal with those old calendar, which has a picture of the Lord?
Well, one thing you could do is to bury them in the ground. You know, you can put them in the ground and let the paper comes from the earth, it comes from the wood which comes from the earth, so you can bury the paper back into the earth.
有一种方式就把它们埋在地里头，放在让它回归土大地，因为它们是由树木，这挂历是用纸张制作的，纸张是来自于木头，木头来自于土壤，所以让它们回归土壤。下一个是还是昨天晚上的 Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 的莲花族顶拜奉献者荣耀归于 Prabhupada 给神像服务不能说话那么给神像做 Arti 做 Arti 的奉献者一边供奉一边跟着大家唱诵可以吗
Yes 可以
可以
Yes you can chant when you're doing Arti Yes
您可以一边做 RT 呢一边就是嘴里唱歌。
Yeah, 可以。
下一个是华为。原子灵魂和至尊灵魂的区别是什么灵魂的实质是什么 ?What's the difference between atomic soul and supreme soul? And what's the essence of the soul?
The atomic soul, that's an individual living entity.And the Supreme Soul was the Paramatma.
原子灵魂它是个体生物，而至尊灵魂是超灵。
So the Paramatma, he's aware about every living entity. He's in the heart of every living entity. He knows about everyone's condition. We only know about our own condition.
超灵他意识到每一个每个生物，它因为它处在每个生物的内心，所以它能够知觉到、意识到每一个生物，知道每一个生物的情况。而我们个体灵魂只能知道自己的情况、状况。
Of course, you also have the soul who is there. The Paramatma is all pervading. He's in the atoms of everything. So she said about.The atomic soul, so maybe she means also the Paramatma who is within the atom.
Oh, 那么就是因为在就是超灵呢，它也在每一个原子当中，所以您这里说的原子灵魂是不是也是指的这位在每一个原子当中的超灵？
So there's a difference, of course, that the soul, the super soul in the heart of the living entity is.Accompanying the individual soul, and he's giving knowledge and remembrance and forgetfulness.
在每个生物体内心的超灵，它陪伴着每一个生物，给予每个生物记忆、知识和遗忘。
But the atomic soul, the soul which is just simply within the atom, that is just providing, is just maintaining the whole creation. It's not actually.Doing any other function than just simply helping to maintain the creation.
而在每一个原子当中的这位超灵的话，它的职能呢，只是在维系着创造，它没有其他的功能。它这个奉献之七份智慧瑜伽是不是等同于业报瑜伽？
Was it?
Well, she's asking, is that the Bodhi Yoga is equal to Karma Yoga?
Well, Bodhi Yoga can be Bhakti Yoga.
智慧瑜伽是就是奉爱瑜伽。
Prabhupada uses the words interchangeably in the Bhagavad Gita.Sometimes he'll put Bodhi Yoga and then he'll put in brackets Bhakti Yoga.
圣帕帕德就在《博伽梵歌》当中呢，他 Bodhi Yoga 和 Bhakti Yoga 智慧瑜伽、奉爱瑜伽，他是互换着使用的。有的时候他用了智慧瑜伽这个词儿，而另外一个时候呢，他又用了奉爱瑜伽这个词。
But generally, Bodhi Yoga is similar to Karma Yoga.Yes. You have to consider the particular contents and where the word is used.
generally it's equal, right?
Yeah.
但是一般而言呢，通常情况下，在普通的情况下，智慧瑜伽就是业报瑜伽。但是呢，您还得根据上下文，根据背景来审视一下。
Yeah. Okay.
下一个是 Rasa Mayi Lakshmi Devadasi。顶拜 Guru 莲花，顶拜 Guru 的莲花座，顶拜您，请教 Guru， 物质生活中总会有掌控人和事的心意和改造人和事的心意，这些 Lotus Feet of Gurudev. And my question is that, in material life, I always want to control other people and other things, and want to reform other people and change other things. And this mind, this mood is not proper for us to practice Krishna consciousness. What's the best for me to do?
Well, the best for you to do is, first of all, reform yourself and change yourself and make yourself Krishna conscious, and then to work on others.
第一件事情是先改造自己，先让自己改变，然后让自己有 Krishna 之觉。第二件事才是在其他人身上花功夫下功夫。
If you are not perfect, then how can you help others?
如果您自己不完美，你又如何能够帮助别人呢？
So you have to first work on yourself, and then you try to give what you've got to others.
首先呢，就是在您把功夫下在您自己身上，然后呢，您在其他人把您所获得的已经获得了再给予其他人。下一个是 Yogita Radha Devadasi. Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada and your Gurudev. Just as you said in the pastime that Bali Maharaj is considered very fortunate because the Lord is constantly staying with him, can we also consider ourselves?To be very fortunate, very, very fortunate to take birth in this human form of body in Kali Yuga, in which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has appeared, and try our best to serve as he has given us the easiest way to purification by chanting and following our Guru's instructions.Yogita Radha Devadasi 说Hare Krishna Gurudev 请接受我卑微的顶拜荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada and 和您 Gurudev 您在消失光当中说就像巴利马拉只认为自己很幸运因为主恒常的和他在一起我们可不可以也是自认为非常非常幸运能够投生在人体生命当中在这个卡里年代投生在人体生命因为主柴丹尼玛哈帕布显现了并且我们尽最大的努力就是按照主柴追随 Gurudev 的训示来通过念诵来获得净化这个是主柴丹尼给予我们的最简易的方法
Yes, we agree. Yeah, that's said in Chaitanya Charitamrita.
我们同意您说的话，这个是也是 Chaitanya Charitamrita 这个书当中所证实的。
We're very fortunate.
我们特别特别幸运。
Okay.
下一个是喜羊羊。顶拜 Gurudev 莲花组和所有奉献者在听 Guru 课的时候做花环和其他的服务是不是会有冒犯
No. You can be hearing at the same time doing service.
没有冒犯，您可以一边聆听一边做服务。下一个是昌支，Velasini Dasi， Hare Krishna， 敬爱的 Guru Dev， 请接受我卑微的顶拜，您甜美的莲花组，一切荣耀归于圣恩 Prabhupada， 顶拜您，顶拜奉献者，请教您，如果我们内心越净化，对经典的理解就越深入。对 Guru 和 Krishna 的感情是不是就越深呢？这样理解正确吗？深深的感恩 Guru Day 的仁慈，谢谢你。Chandra Velasini Dasi said that is that、if we our heart, the more our heart is purified, then the deeper understanding we will have to the scripture, and the deeper feeling we will have.The deeper affection we'll have to gurus and Krishna.
Yeah, we hope so.
希望是我们希望如此。
Yeah. Yeah, we should have nice relationship. We should have faith. We should have faith in both guru and in Krishna. Equal faith. Guru is representative of Krishna.So you must have faith in both Guru and in Krishna.
我们应当对 Guru Krishna 有信心，因为 Guru 是 Krishna 的代表，所以我们应当对 Guru 和 Krishna 怀着同样的、同等的信心。下一个是 Chaitanya Rupa David Dasi Guru 啊，有听说把带有主的画像。和土画挂历用火烧掉和埋在土里一样吗 ？I heard, is it the same that we bury the old calendar, which has the picture of the Lord, and to burn those calendar?
You burn it?
She said, I heard someone said that we can burn the old calendar.
Well, it's not as good as burying it in the ground. It's better if you could just put it in the ground.
不一样，就最好啊，还是把这些旧挂历啊。埋在土壤里。
Yeah, it's a problem.
你这旧挂历确实是个问题。
Nowadays, many calendars they're not putting pictures of the deities. They're not putting pictures. Now, many calendars they just put pictures of people and pictures of trees and nature and like that.
那现在的那些很多挂历就没有神像的照片，只是普通一般人的，上面只有一般人呢，或者是大自然呢，树木啊。
Or some have pictures of the animals, different natures, different creatures.
也有或者是动物的照片呢，或者是大自然的景象。
Flowers.
也有鲜花的照片。
Because it is a problem how to dispose of all these pictures.
确实，就是处理这些图片呢，也成了个问题。
We want to respect the form of the deities, the form of the Lord. Prabhupada taught us.The guru is in his picture. Prabhupada told us that he is in his picture.
Prabhupada 曾经说过，孤儒就在他的照片当中，所以他说过，他也在他的照片当中。
So, yeah, try to be cautious.
所以啊，对这件事情 处理挂历这件事情也要小心。
嗯，还有
下一个是也还有 there are two more questions。第一个是小草，顶麦咕噜，请教咕噜，可以经常记忆 Prabhupada 的消时光吗？ Can we remember the Lila of Srila Prabhupada?
Yes.
可以，应该去记忆 Prabhupada 的消时光。The final one, Radhisham, 顶麦咕噜 Dave, 顶麦翻译和所有奉献者，请问由于自己物质的习性注意不到说话冒犯奉献者，也许自己也意识不到冒犯了多少奉献者，怎么才能消除这些冒犯，恢复念诵圣名的品位呢？ Due to our
offended devotees, how to get rid of the offense?
Yes.
Well, when we offend the devotees, if you have to be cautious thatoffense against devotees is very bad, right? So if we offend devotees, we have to go to the devotee and beg forgiveness.
我们要小心，因为冒犯奉献者非常糟糕。如果冒犯的话，我们应该要去那个被冒犯的奉献者面前呢，恳求他的宽恕。
And if you're not able to get forgiveness, then you should try to serve the devotee you've offended. Try to render them service.
如果不能得到被冒犯的奉献者的宽恕，那么应该努力的来服务这些被冒犯的奉献者。
And Prabhupada taught us every day when we meet devotees, we should offer our respectful obeisances to the devotees, and that helps us to get rid of all of our offenses.
师父普罗帕德告诉我们，每天当我们和奉献者见面的时候，都应当向他们致以虔敬的顶拜，去除这些冒犯。
Mm, yeah.
So that's... 那个还有一位举手呢，他叫 Yogita Rata。请你说话，那位马大姐，我已经给你解除静音了。
Yogita Radha Mother, you can speak. Unmute yourself.
Oh, Mataji, you already asked my question. Thank you very much.
Okay.
I didn't know that Chaitanya Charitamrita says that good. Thank you so very much. More eager to read now. Thank you.
他的问题刚才已经说过了，念过了。现在还有最后一个 Sati 的 Mataji 的问题。Mar, do you have time to answer? Okay. Sati 说，顶拜 Guru 奉献者，请问 Guru， 我们没有扎甘纳的神像，怎么做 Snana Yatra 和 Radha Yatra？
Well, other people have find somebody who's got it. You can watch. You can go on television online and watch it. The Radha Yatra in Jagannath Puri, they put it on the television and on the radio and.Everybody is watching it all over India, so you can probably get it also on the internet. You can watch the whole Radha Yatra in Jagannath Puri online.
您可以就是因在那个电视上，您可以去找，他们会在电视上呢播放在扎格纳布里举行的弹车节，就在网络上，就您可以在网上在线上观看，或者是在网上找。
And all the temples in India, all ISKCON temples in India, they're having Radha Yatra on the same day. The same day is the Radha Yatra in Jagannath Puri.
在印度，所有 ISKCON 的庙宇都会和扎格纳布里举办弹车节，在同一天举办弹车节。
So.Probably they'll be televising different Radha Yatras online. You can watch.
很可能呢，他们会在线播放这个弹车节。你们可以去在线观看。
So, in that way, you can participate by watching.
你们是通过 在线观看弹车节，来参与弹车节。
Okay, yeah.
没有 ，no more.
Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you, Guru Mani, for all.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank all the devotees. Okay, have a good week. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda Ki Jai.
Jai.